Hello everyone. Today I will discuss a very important topic which most of the students find difficult, and it is angles in parallel lines. And we always represent your angles in the parallel lines by using a diagram like this, where L is parallel to M. And there are different angles which we can work with the parallel lines. And the first type of angle is corresponding angles. Now, in corresponding angles, the corresponding angles are always equal. So if I represent a diagram like this, where you're this line and this line is parallel, angle 1 is corresponding to angle 2, angle 3 is corresponding to angle 4. Similarly, if I draw another diagram where L and M, they are parallel to each other, and angle 5 will be corresponding to angle 6. Angle 7 will be corresponding to angle 8. That means the corresponding angles, like angle 1 should be equals to angle 2, angle 3 should be equals to angle 4, angle 5 should be equals to angle 6, and angle 7 should be equals to angle 8. So if you will see the diagram, it looks like one angle below the other. Then we have another set of angles, which are alternate angles. Alternate angles means the angles which are there in Z between the parallel lines. Like, for example, this one. It represents your Z or Z. You can say it as Z or Z. Then, if I will draw another one where your two lines are parallel, and I will take your this one. This also represents Z, but a mirror image of Z. So the angle A and B, they are alternate. Angle C and angle D, they are alternate. That means alternate angles are equal in the parallel lines. That means angle A is equals to angle B, angle C is equals to angle D. Then we have another set of angles which is called as co-interior angles. The co-interior angles between the parallel lines are 1 and 2. They are co-interior angles. Then 3 and 4, that pair is also co-interior angle. So in the parallel lines, the sum of co-interior angle should be equals to 180 degree. That means angle 3 plus angle 4 also should be equals to 180 degree. Then we can see another set of angles when we are working with the angles in the parallel lines, and that is a straight angle. Now, as the term suggested, straight angle will be on the straight line. So if I will take this line, and if I will be able to make a half circle on this line, so this angle 1 and this angle 2, that means this one and this one. This represent your angle 1 and this represent your angle 2. So the sum of angle 1 and angle 2 should be equals to 180 degree. That's what the straight angles rule say. So if I have to make a parallel line here, and if I want to find out what is the sum of angle 1, angle 2, or if I need to find out what is the sum of angle 2 and angle 3, if I want to find out what is the sum of angle 5 and angle 6, that means it should be 180 degree. So angle 2 plus angle 3 also should be 180 degree because it is also making a half circle. Angle 5 plus angle 6 also should be 180 degree because it is also making a half circle. Then we have another set of angles, which is vertical opposite angles. And vertical opposite angles are always in the cross. That means this angle 1 and angle 2, it's vertical opposite. Angle 3 and angle 4, it is also vertical opposite. That means angle 1 should be equals to angle 2, angle 3 should be equals to angle 4. And in the parallel lines, you can see there are crosses. If I will draw two parallel lines with a transversal line, so this is one cross, and this is the another one. Now, when I have to work with such questions, I need to see which angles are vertical opposite. So if I'll do angle one here, angle two, that means it's vertical opposite angle. Then if I'll do here three and four, it is vertical opposite angle. So they are equal. If I will work here with five and six, so angle five is equals to angle six. If I will work here seven and eight, so angle seven is equals to angle eight. So these are the angles which are very important in the parallel lines. Now let's do some questions to know the application of these angles whenever we are working with the questions of parallel lines. So you can see here two different questions. In the first question, if I have to find out A, which rule I will use here? The angles on the straight line, that means the sum of 110 degree plus A should be equals to 180. So that means A should be equals to 180 degree minus 110 degree, which is equals to 70 degree. That means the value of A is 70 degree. Now, next one is angle A is equals to angle B. Why it is equal? Because here the angles are corresponding angles and the corresponding angles are always equal. That means if angle A is equals to 70 degree, that means angle B should be equals to 70 degree. Similarly, in the second question, if I'll see A and 100 degree, they are in the cross, and in the cross they are vertical opposite. So we can write A is equals to 100 degree. Why? Because vertical opposite angles. Now, similarly, if I have to find out the value of angle C, now we already know angle A is 100 degree. Now, angle A and angle C, they are co-interior angles, and we already know the sum of co-interior angle is equals to 180 degree. So we'll write down angle A plus angle C is equals to 180 degree because co-interior angles. Now we already know the value of angle A is equals to 100. We write down here 100 degree plus angle C equals to 180 degree, and angle C will be equals to 180 degree minus 100 degree, which is equals to 80 degree. Now we already know what is the value of angle C, which is 80 degree. Now if you will see this part, it's making a Z, and in the Z we can see that angle A is equals to angle B is equals to 100 degree. Why? Because they are alternate angles. This is how we can solve the variety of questions related to the parallel lines. If you like the video, hit the like and subscribe button. Share my channel link with your friends and help my channel to grow so that I can help the other students to understand maths in a better way.